Hello, planet Earth. Welcome to my YouTube channel. We're at IDK, my BFF Jill 730. I'm Preston L. Young, wishing you warm salutations and congratulations as always. You've made your way to the Buffington Post. So today I'll be continuing my Season 9 coverage with Buffy the Vampire Slayer Season 9, issue number 10, It's a Part of Me, Part 3. This cover's really great. It's got all of the myriad thoughts running through Buffy's mind, and they are all pretty self-deprecating, but hey, that's Buffy. She likes to be down on herself. Alright, so previously on Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
This guy called the Siphon was trying to suck out Buffy's power, but he noticed that Buffy's power was really different. So he was talking to Simone in the hospital after Detective Dowling all shot him up, right? So Simone decided to take matters into her own hands and go after Buffy herself. So we've got Xander and Dawn who are living together, shacked up, trying to be out of the supernatural, but in the last issue they got dragged all up into Detective Dowling's problems because his partner Chung had been made into a vampire and they had to go track down and kill Miranda Chung. So that's what's up. Willow has of course left to go and put magic back together somehow. We don't know how, she just showed up over in England with Angel and Faith, so we'll see how that shakes out a little bit later. Buffy had been having these dreams wherein the first Slayer said, "You are not the Slayer," and then this fairy girl told her, "You're not a girl anymore." So, you know, Buffy had been thrown up and period was late, so she took a pregnancy test and whoop-de-doo, she's pregnant. So she goes through all this drama, finally decides that she's going to have an abortion. Well then, holy crap, she's not pregnant, she's a robot. Andrew had switched her body with this robot Buffy body and put her mind in the robot and just stuck this blank Buffy out in the suburbs in this cushy little 9-to-5 life where she doesn't know anything about being a Slayer. So this was fine, Buffy and Spike and Andrew went to go and retrieve Buffy's body, but Simone got to it first and kidnapped the body. So Simone has apparently brainwashed this blank Buffy, and at the end of the last issue when they split up to try and find the body and whomever, you know, kidnapped Buffy's body, yeah, the blank Buffy came along and knocked out robot Buffy and said, "Hey, I've been liberated."
And that's where we are. So with no further ado, it's... Oh, and hey, planet Earth. I'm switching things up a little bit with the intro and outro. See, the theme song I have here is a TV theme song, but in the TV show, it comes at the end of the show. And so there will be an opening credit sequence, but it won't. It'll be more like my outro, and the outro will be more like an intro ought to be. So just to, you know, clarify. Buffy the Vampire Slayer, Season 9, Issue Number 10, A Part of Me, Part 3. Here we go.
When problems overwhelm us and sadness smothers us, where do we find the will and the courage to continue? Well, the answer may come in the caring voice of a friend, a chance encounter with a book, or from a personal faith. For Janet, help came from her faith, but it also came from a squirrel. Shortly after her divorce, Janet lost her father. Then she lost her job. She had mounting money problems. But Janet not only survived, she worked her way out of despondency, and now she says life is good again. How could this happen? She told me that late one autumn day, when she was at her lowest, she watched a squirrel storing up nuts for the winter. One at a time, he would take them to the nest. And she thought, if that squirrel can take care of himself with a harsh winter coming on, so can I. Once I broke my problems into small pieces, I was able to carry them, just like those acorns, one at a time.
Okay, so I'm just gonna fly through the recap for this issue because there's really not a whole lot going on. It's not an issue that I particularly like, but it's one that I love for its, like, last 5 pages, right? So Buffy has been all tied to a chair and she's like, oh, she kind of comes to and she says, you know, you really don't look kidnapped. And so the blank Buffy is saying, yeah, well, I'm not kidnapped. I'm free. You should try it sometime. Buffy's like, oh, really? You think you're free? You left that nice-ass house in the suburbs to come be free in this nasty-smelling basement? Come on now. So Buffy, the blank Buffy, feels really betrayed by herself. She feels like she's betrayed herself. She believes that Buffy just kind of shirked her responsibilities and stuck her in this fake life with these fake friends and just trying to ignore her problems. Everything that Simone has told her has been that Buffy did this to herself. Now, we know that Andrew did it, but it's really, you know, not been made clear to anybody but the Buffy in the Buffy bot about all this. It's so crazy. But anyway, so the blank Buffy is angry with herself in the robot body for coming up with this plan. And Buffy says, hey, dude, it's not my plan. So they're talking back and forth, and basically the blank Buffy says, you know what, you don't deserve to be a Slayer. And we see Buffy remembering that the Slayer told her, you're not the Slayer anymore. She says, look at you, all you did was like build up this army of disciples and then you didn't arm them. And Buffy at this point realizes, oh, she's got these purple streaks in her hair, she's talking about being liberated, And, you know, now she wants guns. So clearly she puts the pieces together and says, Simone. Well, Simone comes in and Simone says, you know what? I really thought you were a piece of shit. You are such a coward. You're so stupid. You really thought you'd get away with putting your body out here and I wouldn't find it. Well, I found it and that's what I needed. You see, Simone has found out that what she doesn't have that Buffy does have is power. Buffy has been getting more and more powerful every day that she's been the Slayer. And she's been the Slayer for like 10 years now. And so she is physically more filled with the Slayer power than any of the other Slayers out there in the world right now because she's been cultivating it for the longest. And Simone basically needs this power. And when she found out that the Buffy she found in San Francisco was not powered by the Slayer power, she decided to start looking elsewhere, and that's when she found Buffy's body. Now, Buffy doesn't understand how it was that she could have found out that she was not the Slayer and that her power was all weird and not, you know, Slayer power. But Simone knocks her one good, and she basically says, shut the fuck up, we're gonna have some fun with you. Buffy says, look at Simone and look at yourself, blank Buffy. She's different from us. You aren't like her. So Simone says, hey, this has been fun, but we're really going to have some fun because I've got these tools and we're going to play Operation on your robot body. So Spike had, of course, found Simone's van, but due to the fact that the sun came up, he's hiding out in the van. So Andrew comes upon the van and he finds Spike and they see that there are all of these guns in the van. And so Spike's bugs show up to give them a little bit of backup. So back in San Francisco, Dawn is trying to get in touch with Buffy, but she can't, and Detective Dowling is talking to his sergeant about what happened with Chung and how he had to, put her down. And the police are finally finding out that the vampire situation is something that they are going to have to take into their own hands because these zompires are just super cray. So back with Buffy, Simone, and the blank Buffy, Simone is talking about how she's got this great master plan, and Buffy says, well, hey, what is it? And Simone says, I'm not stupid, I'm not about to tell you my whole plan, but I'll tell you what, if we can figure out where they keep the essence of you in here, we might just keep the head so you can see for yourself. So, the alarm goes off because Spike and Andrew and the bugs have come in to rescue Buffy, and Simone goes to investigate what's turning the siren on. So at this point, Buffy says, I think you girls have the right idea. And she actually headbutts her own shoulder off so that she is freed from her restraints. The blank Buffy says, oh, let me guess, you want to talk? And Buffy says, no, not if you don't. So Buffy starts trying to knock some sense into herself. So we pick up with Spike and Andrew and the bugs. And Spike is fighting Simone while Andrew goes to try and, you know, find the Buffies. So, Andrew comes upon Buffy fighting with herself. Yeah, he tries to pitch in, but Buffy says, hold on. She pins down the blank Buffy, and she says, let's try and talk some sense into myself. So, Simone is kicking Spike's cockroaches' asses, and then she goes after Spike, and he says, oh, and here I thought I had killed my last Slayer. She says, oh, trust me, you have, and so has Buffy. So she doesn't get Spike good and stake, but she picks up her gun and she starts shooting at everybody. And at this point, Buffy and Andrew have talked sense into the blank Buffy, and so Simone starts shooting at everybody and she shoots Buffy in the robot body. But she's a robot, she's fine. So Simone gets away before we figure out what she was up to. Now the blank Buffy says that she was trying to do something with Buffy, trying to tap into some kind of power, and she also had this other, like, backup plan, but she doesn't know what it is. It just had something to do with something in the city. So, back in the city, we pick up with Dowling, and he has gone to put in his resignation in the police force, because basically, all of the cops around him are looking at him like a murderer, like what he did to Miranda was, you know, awful, but the sergeant tells him, I get it, and these people right here, they couldn't do what you did. And so he and Dowling start to talk about this vampire task force that he wants to get off the ground. So by this point, Buffy, Spike, Andrew, and the blank Buffy have come back to San Francisco, and Spike basically says, hey dude, I'm out of here. You know, you wanted to run away with me when you thought you were pregnant, so why not now? Why don't you come away with me now? And, you know, she's not going to. And Spike says, you know what, I'm over this. I'm really over it, Buffy. You keep putting me on the back burner. You know, I'm last thought in your head. You can't just keep treating me like this and expecting me to just hang around, because I'm in love with you and you need to figure your shit out. And I think you can do that better without me around. So Spike says, holla back, bye, Felicia. So they're going to put Buffy's mind and body back together, right? And Buffy says, you know, maybe this is a mistake. She had a nice cushy life out there. You could repair my robot body. I can go out and slay and still kind of do my shitty life thing. And we can put her back in this perfect life. She can meet the perfect guy and have the kids and just have the life that Buffy's never going to have. So Blank Buffy says, hey, dude, I'm right here, and here's what you're failing to realize. Yeah, Simone, she was crazy, and she was able to brainwash me, but the fact of the matter is, she wasn't lying to me the way that I was lying to myself. There was something wrong there, and even though I didn't know what it was, there was something missing from my life, and I could feel it. And when Simone came along, she reignited the spark that Andrew had really put out in me. You know, I can't not be the Slayer. There's this part of me that I need to explore. And Buffy says, yeah, I get what you're saying. It's just, I'm never going to have a life like that. And the Blank Buffy tells her, you can have a life like that, Buffy, but it won't mean anything unless you really earn it for yourself. You know, on your own terms and through your own struggles and tribulations. You can't just get this free thing. That's not how life works. And I like this. This is Buffy talking sense into herself. And this is just a really lovely thing that only the Buffyverse can really do like this. So Buffy goes to work and she's talking to Root about how, oops, you know, she hadn't been there for the past few days. So Root says, look, you know, you can't just dip out like that. You're not on the schedule yet, but I can work you in if you're going to actually stick around. By the way, your friend Kennedy came along and she said she tried calling you, but it went straight to voicemail. I myself have had the same problem trying to call you. And yeah, she left you this note. So Buffy's reading the note and she says, hey, you haven't got me on the schedule, right? He says, that's correct. She says, well, you can consider this my resignation. And that's where we end the issue. So whatever Kennedy is offering Buffy is better than dealing out coffee. So that's interesting. Something I forgot about is that Buffy herself has been forgetting about Dawn. She tells Spike, oh, I keep forgetting about Dawn. Now, this is really weird because, you know, I said it when Buffy found out she was pregnant. Buffy already has a child. Dawn is her child. And Buffy has been trying to let Dawn and Xander go be their normal, shacked up people away from the supernatural for now, but Dawn really does still need Buffy. She's the only parent figure that has been, you know, consistent in her life. And this whole thing of Buffy trying to let Dawn lead a normal life without her, it goes to the problem with Buffy herself. Buffy, since she destroyed the Seed of Wonder, has been just basically saying, well, no more problems. You know, I don't have any more problems because there's no more magic. But just because there's no more magic doesn't mean that Buffy stops being who she is. She's thinking that she can live this normal life and have these normal roommates and life is just going to be hunky-dory. And, you know, that's just not the case. She is literally betraying herself. She's denying herself a life and then she's denying herself her slayerhood. Her real body could not defend itself because she didn't know that she was a slayer. And Buffy couldn't be a real person because she was a robot. And so you have Buffy and then you've got the Vampire Slayer. And what Buffy tells herself is that she has to be both. She can't have one without the other. You can get rid of magic, but you can't get rid of who you are. You are always going to have these responsibilities and you have to figure out your life. There's not some great big fix. You don't get to be a robot and you don't get to go out and live in the suburbs. You have to be you, like 100% all the time. And that's going to be hard, but it's better hard and earned than easy and free. And this goes back to what I was saying about why Giles would leave everything to Faith, because Buffy did get really cushy in just the idea of having this normal life. And if Giles had given her money and a house and everything she needs for a normal life, she would have tried to ignore being the Slayer and, again, shirk her responsibilities. And I really like this. And Buffy is going to go from being Coffee Girl to being a robot. And hopefully by the end of season 9, she'll realize that she is not Buffy and she's not the Vampire Slayer, but she is Buffy, the Vampire Slayer. And there's no getting around that at all. As for Spike, I like that he talks and sense into himself too. He says, you know what, Buffy, I'm not going to be your bitch forever, and you can't keep treating me as though I don't have feelings and, like, I don't care about you. Because he does love Buffy, but at the same time, he's not going to hurt himself just to try and make her feel better. And so I really like this. I like that Spike is going to go and try and be his own person and try and allow for Buffy to be her own person as well. Like I said, this issue, it just really flies by really quickly. I don't like that everything with Simone gets wrapped up really, really quickly, but it really works at the end with Buffy literally talking some sense into herself. And you know, what I really like about this issue overall is the truth to it. There are points in your life where you have to sit down with yourself and say, this is not working for me. What I'm doing is not going to fit into my truth, you know, like hashtag live your truth. That's what Buffy's trying to do. And like, that's what I really like about this. It's because, you know, like I said, there are these times in your life where you have to decide where you're going to go moving forward. And sometimes you just have to start from scratch. It's not always easy, but it's better to know that you're not on the right path than to stay on the wrong one, you know? Andrew is going to kind of fade away for a minute, but it's fine. He'll be back toward the end of the season. And yeah, I'm interested to see what Kennedy has to offer us as the season progresses as well. So stay tuned. Next, we're going to do our What's at Stake, the Pit Stop Part 2 for the second arcs of Buffy and Angel and Faith. Now, Buffy Season 10, number 20, will be out this coming Wednesday on the 21st, I believe. Don't quote me. I don't really know what day it is. But anyway, have a great day. We'll see you next time. You can like, comment, share, subscribe, and as always, question. Hope you're having a great 2015 so far. Bye.
Hey, baby, I hear the blues are calling. Tossed salads and scrambled eggs. Mercy. And maybe I seem a bit confused. Yeah, maybe. But I got you pegged. Ha! But I don't know what to do with those tossed salads and scrambled eggs. They're calling again. Scrambled eggs all over my face. What is a boy to do?